Hello comrades, welcome back to Commander Peter Askiski, and today comrades we are going to be doing the Russian Revolution. One of the best moments in all of history comrades, so I am very excited for this episode. Now comrades, before we continue this mini-series comrades, these two episodes I am doing over the next 2 days comrades, it is with collaboration with Premier Ivan. Go subscribe to him, I appeared on his talk show, the Premier Show comrades, so go check that shit out. And anyway comrades, let's begin.
It's time to learn history now! Causes!
Comrades, one of the main reasons for the Russian Revolution happening was obviously Russia was very poor. Comrades, it was quite far stuck in the past, obviously, because of the shitty imperialist government, comrades. The government was shit, it didn't want to help people, meaning people's lives were shit, they were poor, comrades. It was just a bunch of shit, comrades. Comrades, I'll be honest, it was quite bullshit. Comrades, other reasons. It obviously, growth of communism was happening, comrades, which obviously led people like Lenin to rise to power, maybe Soviets appearing in many parts of St. Petersburg, or then known as Petrograd, Moscow, comrades, obviously all that bullshit. You also had things such as World War I going shit for Russia, comrades. And, thank Tsar Nicholas for that bullshit. Wow, comrade, thank you. You are really a disappointment to our history. But yes, comrades, all these led to many revolutions, which we'll talk about the 1905 revolution, the February revolution, and the beautiful communist revolution, comrades. So, yes, let's talk about the event.
The event.
So, comrades, the start of the 1905 revolution, comrades, which many, it was led by a priest, comrades, who led many people on a very peaceful protest, comrades, to slowly push into the capital to give, you know, tell Tsar Nicholas, bullshit man, give us some the good life, comrades. And guess what? Tsar Nicholas being the absolute pussy hole, he fucking ran. Comrades, I am leaving. Comrades, in his place he left the army. And the army, they were pretty stupid. Stupid imperialist army, comrades, which just shot the protesters, which, you know, caused a lot of havoc, riots, comrades, and all that bullshit, which led to different governments being created. But in the end, the Tsar lost no power, and he just went, wow, fuck you, protesters, wow. Comrades, that is definitely what the Tsar did, trust me. Comrades, obviously after that, we have Rasputin, comrades, who, well, let's just say he was a bit more bullshit than the average human, comrades. He kind of started being nice with the Tsar by helping out his son heal, comrades, and all that bullshit. Apparently he was so-called magical, but he was just kind of smarter than the average Russian, comrades. Let's just say Russia was quite stupid before the Soviet times. Yes, and, well, it seemed like Rasputin was kind of controlling the Tsar and influencing him a lot, comrades, so many people were quite against that. But then, comrades, it didn't matter because many things such as the war with Japan happened where Russia's got his ass kicked. Comrades, do one thing right, you pussyhole. Do one thing right. Hello, Japan. Are you ready to fight? Ah, yes. Comrade, I am going to fuck your shit. And yes, comrades, the Russians, well, they lost that war as well, but then World War I happened, comrades, where the Russians wanted to defend the Serbians and, well, oh my god, comrade! Comrades, the Russians got their ass kicked by the Germans, comrades, yes, and even Austria-Hungary, which is probably the most embarrassing part of the whole situation. And yes, comrades, obviously after all that bullshit, the Russians were being pushed back even further, comrades, which... obviously led the Tsar, you know, because of shortages of food and shit, the Tsar was like, you know what, I'm quite a pussyhole, but I'm still going to try to be the military commander of this shit, for some reason, comrades. And well, he went, comrades, and left his German wife, and Rasputin, comrades, to be in charge of the country, Jesus Christ. Comrades eventually led to, well, the February Revolution, comrades, where people were protesting. They wanted food rations, they wanted better housing, they wanted better shit. No imperialism, comrades, they wanted socialism, they wanted communists to come to power, comrades. But comrades, the protests were getting so bad that eventually the Tsar had to abdicate, comrades, which led many, many Soviets, you know, like Leon Trotsky, Stalin, Lenin, to come more to power. And obviously, Tsar Nicholas finally fucked off, and 300 years of the Romanov dynasty, well, just to got put in the bin, comrades. Now, comrades, obviously I've explained the February Revolution to you, comrades, but let's just quickly allow Premier Ivan, comrades, let him tell you some more shit. Come on, Premier.
Basically, comrades, the Russian Revolution, there was actually two revolutions. One was the February Revolution, where they tried to abdicate the Tsar, which was successful, which was the fall of the Russian Empire and the establishment of the Russian Provisional Government. The first leader was Georgi Lyubov. And then, after the embarrassing Kerensky offensive during the First World War, Alexander Kerensky became, you know, the ruler of the Russian republics, which was actually established in September. Then the October Revolution happened, which actually happened on November 7th, 1917, when Vladimir Lenin and his coup took over the Petrograd, which currently today is St. Petersburg, comrades. And yeah, that's how the Russian Civil War basically began.
But even this revolution, comrades, it created a power balance between two different governments, which Lenin, let's just say, comrades, he didn't like that shit. He was brought back from Switzerland, given to Russia, comrades, and he wanted to start the biggest revolution the world has ever seen, which, let's just say, he did quite a good job, comrades, because, well, he started the communist revolution, which is our final revolution, comrades. So, comrades, Lenin came, comrades, and there was massive protests happening, comrades, in support of the Soviet. Even the prime minister, he gave the Bolsheviks, comrades, he gave them guns to help protect Petrograd, but they ended up betraying him. They were like, no, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. And comrades, it was quite the biggest bullshit. Comrades, well, after all this bullshit, you know, comrades, let's just say the Bolsheviks were quite in a good situation. Now, eventually, the Soviets, they took Petrograd. They marched down, took the palace, comrades, and eventually, well, they just had power over the whole country, comrades. Good job. That is quite a good job. Well done. Well done, Soviets. Wow. Well done. I am proud of you. I'm very proud. And well, comrades, obviously, after a peace treaty with the Germans, it looked pretty good for the Soviets until the Russian Civil War, which we'll discuss next episode, comrades.
Effects!
Now, comrades, the effects, obviously, the Tsar being removed. 300 years of the Romanov dynasty, fucked off, comrades. That's probably one of the biggest effects. Another big effect, start of the Russian Civil War, comrades, which, well, killed millions, comrades, over the entire Russian Federation. And well, comrades, also communism finally coming to power in our country, comrades. The beautiful Soviet Union started becoming established. Not yet, comrades, but it was the good beginnings, comrade. But anyway, comrades, thank you for watching this video. Thank you to Premier Ivan for helping me, comrades. And make sure to let communism strike again.